touch start to begin. The cost will be changing.
They're going to do away with the bonus. That's what they voted on today to get rid of that.
Well, if they fix the subway, I'll give up the bonus. I want to see it fixed first.
38 passed. So it's 121 now. It's 127. So that's $6.
I don't want to give you more money for worse service.
We heard today at the board meeting that this is not a hike. It is a hike. It's a hike because Long Island Road riders are paying doubly.
Inside MTA headquarters, board members debate and ultimately approve new fares and tolls and promises of reforms, consolidations, and better MTA operations.
Okay. We're making demonstrations that we're doing that. After all that's done, what else have you got? We're going to have to pay for this.
People need to know where the money's going. They need better transparency. They need more understanding. And that's my job in talking to everybody.
Here's the cost for subways and buses effective April 21st. No bonus means a swipe is $2.75, $3 for a single ride. Increases for the price of express bus and unlimited Metro cards are posted there. On the LIRR and Metro North, again on April 21st, passes increase 3.85% or less. That increase is no more than $15 for monthly tickets and no more than $5.75 for weekly. No increase if monthly or weekly tickets are at a certain point. New tolls take effect March 31st. Budget about a 6% increase with your Easy Pass and a nearly 12% increase without it.
MTA and transit officials will also be keeping an eye on service promises and delays as they report those are down. Still, the amount of work is up, and that's why now the real conversation shifts to the legislature about congestion pricing to fund further improvement projects. I put all the prices because they are different for the tickets, for the railroads, for the tolls at certain bridges and crossings, all of those on pix11.com and on my social media posts. Live outside MTA headquarters at Bowling Green, Greg Mocker, Pix 11 News.